Welcome back to Humanities section. Today we are going to take up Geography. And today I am going to start with the chapter number 2, that is the formation of the Earth. I am skipping the first chapter because it is very much and we will do it later as it is less important. This chapter is an interesting one and so we should start with this one only. So let's start with the first chapter, formation of the Earth. Okay, let me bring it closer for your better understanding, so that you can see it properly. Formation of the Earth, that is its age and origin, are shrouded in mystery. Shrouded means covered in mystery. Nobody exactly knows as to when and from where the Earth came into being. Several scientists have tried to calculate the age of the Earth and to investigate into its origin, but no final conclusion has arrived till date. The results and findings in research in regard to the age and origin are so varied and contrasting that it becomes impossible to arrive at a convincing conclusion which may be accepted by majority of the scientists. So from here we can see that many scientists have tried their best to investigate on the age and origin of the Earth, but their process is so varied and different that it cannot be accepted by majority of the scientists. So it is still surrounded by mystery. No one exactly till date knows the proper age and origin of the Earth. So today we are going to do the age of the Earth. And in the next video we are going to do about the origin of the Earth. So today let's take up age of the Earth. Age of the Earth. It is generally believed that the Earth is 4 to 5 billion old. Almost nothing is known of the conditions of the Earth during the first 1 billion years before its consolidation in the crust. There are many methods which have evolved in the last two centuries that helps us to estimate the age of the Earth, some of which are given below. First one is the tidal force theory. Tidal force theory was given by Sir George Darwin, who is the son of famous biologist Charles Darwin. So what did he say? He has said that by the method of tidal force, age of Earth can be calculated in two ways. First method. It was earlier believed that Moon originated from the Earth because it revolves around the Earth and behaves as its satellite. So earlier it was believed that the Moon originated from the Earth as it behaves as its satellite. It is also believed that the Moon was very close to the Earth at the time of its birth, and the tidal friction of the Moon was maximum. As the time passed, the Moon moved away from the Earth and its tidal friction reduced. The age of the Moon and consequently the age of the Earth is calculated depending upon the rate of decrease of tidal friction of the Moon. On the basis of this, the age of the Earth has been calculated as 4 billion years. So it is saying that earlier it was believed that the Moon has originated from the Earth and behaved as a satellite. With the passage of time, it has moved far away from the Earth, which resulted in the decrease of its tidal friction. So if we can know the rate of decrease of tidal friction, we can calculate the age of the Earth. By this method, the age of the Earth is 4 billion years. He has also said another second methodology. What was that? Scientific study of tides and rotation of the Earth has proved that the Moon is moving away from the Earth at a rate of 13 cm per year. By research we have understood that the Earth is moving at a rate of 13 cm per year. At present, the Moon is 384,000 km away from the Earth. The Moon would have taken 2.95 billion years to move this distance. Since the Earth was born much earlier than the Moon, the age of the Earth is determined at 4 billion years on the basis of this calculation. So on the basis of this calculation, the age of the Earth is 4 billion years. But here I want to say that it is not given in your book, but it has some contradictions too. During the 1970s, USA, that is NASA, has sent many expeditions on the Moon. They have found out that the rocks present on the Moon has its age is definitely much more than that of the Earth, which completely makes this claim false that the Moon has originated from the Earth. So, but on that evidence, we cannot say that it is a perfect method. So it has been discarded and it is of no use in the modern age. You keep it in mind as a fact. Okay. Next, let's go to the second method. It is sedimentation. The sedimentary rocks are deposited by various agents of denudation like water, wind, snow, etc. The process of sedimentation continued ever since the earth cooled from liquid to solid state and is still continuing. The continuing sedimentation resulted into the thickening of sedimentary rocks. If we are able to know the thickness of the sedimentation and the annual rate of thickening, then the age of the formation of the first sedimentary rocks on the surface of the earth may be determined, which helps us to estimate the age of the earth. So it is saying that ever since the earth has cooled, it has been weathered, and this led to the thickening of sedimentary rocks. So now, if we can calculate the thickening of the sediment and as well by the rate and divide it by the rate of the deposition of sediment, we can be able to get the age of the earth. This method suffers from two defects. Like the previous one, this also has certain defects. What are they? The rate of sedimentation per year is not the same every year, and it differs from place to place. Exactly. And point number two, many interruptions occur in the sequence of sedimentary rocks. So due to these two points, we can say that this method is also not perfect. The next method is rate of erosion. Some geologists believe that they can calculate the age of the earth on the basis of the erosion of land masses. It is believed that the continental land masses are continuously being eroded by exogenous or denudational processes. Here one term is that exogenous. What is exogenous? Exogenous means the processes that occur on or outside the surface of the earth. And endogenous, completely opposite to that, that is the processes that occur in the inside of the earth. Exogenous processes mainly include weathering or denudation. It is given here. So ever since the continental landmasses were formed, they are getting weathered. If we are able to find out the total amount of denudation of the surface material still now and the annual rate of denudation, then the age of the earth could be calculated. The same method, but they are doing it in different way. The same method, that is the rate. We have to find the rate and the total. However, this method is not very accurate for determination of the age of the earth. However, this is not accurate because erosion, alike sediments, eroded particles also varied from place to place, time to time, as is, and it is not uniform. So you cannot be fully 100% sure that this is only the age of the earth. Next method is the salinity of the oceans. Many scholars used to believe that oceans contain pure water, that is, water without salt at the time of their formation. Today, the ocean water contains a lot of salt, as a result of which they have saline water. This salt has been carried from the continents to the ocean by the rivers. If the total amount of oceanic salt is known and the annual rate of increase of oceanic salinity is determined, the age of the oceans may be calculated. So what they are saying, that many scholars used to believe that earlier the ocean had pure water, and the landmass, and from the landmasses only the salts have came and deposited over the ocean, saline in nature. So if we are able to know the thickness, the total oceanic salt, and divide it by the annual rate of oceanic salinity, we would be able to get the age of the earth. John Jolly calculated the mass of the salt brought by the rivers per year is up to 156 million metric tons. He also concluded that the amount of salt in the oceanic water is about 12.6 billion metric tons. Thus, the age of the ocean is calculated as, by this we have to divide both 12.6 billion by 156 billion, which is coming as 80 million years. John Jolly also suggested that the earth came into existence much earlier than the oceans were formed. Some scientists believe that the ocean was formed at least 40 million before the birth of the earth. Thus, the age of the earth, according to this calculation, is 80 plus 40 equals to 120 million years. So here is the calculation. It is not required. Now, it has also certain defects. See, it has three main defects. Number one, this estimate is far too low, as Jolly failed to take into account the salt that is removed from the sea and is taken as a part of marine sediments. It is definitely that certain salt also gets deposited as sediments, so it is lost. So he had not taken that. erosion of Earth's surface is not uniform everywhere, as I have told you in the previous also. And the convection currents rising from the core of the Earth also bring some salt in them. These are the three points that proves the defectiveness of this method. Last method is radioactivity. Radioactivity is the most modern among all these methods and is the most reliable method. This method was discovered by whom? It was discovered by Pierre Curie. In 1903, he stated that all radioactive elements release heat, disintegrate and generate heat. The rate of generation depends upon the nature of elements. Uranium and thorium contain the maximum amount of radioactive elements. Scientist Rutherford said that in 1904, that the age of the rocks can be calculated on the basis of this radioactive elements. If we know the rate of disintegration and the mass of remaining elements, we can know the years during which the element has reached the present condition. The rate of disintegration is usually expressed in half lifetime period. For example, uranium loses half of its mass in 4.56 billion years. Nowadays, half life period of the elements can be easily calculated by Giger counter. Uranium is converted into lead by the process of disintegration. The weight of lead as a disintegration of uranium is found. By knowing the rate of disintegration, we can calculate the age of the Earth. From this method, the age of the Earth is estimated to be 4 to 5 billion years. So, Rutherford said that by using radioactive elements, we can determine the age of the rocks. Here, uranium loses half of its mass. Always remember that the calculation of age is done on a half lifetime period. So uranium loses half of its mass in 4.6 billion years, and has converted into what? Into lead. We have now calculated the age of the age of lead, and by this method we can say that the age of the Earth is almost 4 to 5 billion years. So these are the five methods by which we can determine the age of the Earth. Out of this, the radioactivity method is widely accepted. Rest all methods have their defects, and that's why they are discarded. Today I am doing up to this only. From next day we are gonna do the origin of the Earth, the various hypotheses on this fact, and the most important of them is the Big Bang theory. That I will do in the next class. Until then, goodbye. Thank you.